Hey guys, what's up? Spectre here. And we've never been so close to Cyberpunk, which has me equally nervous and excited. But there's still tons of news to talk about as we count down the days to December 10th. I'll be discussing Cyberpunk on Stadia, devs' reactions to gameplay on the Xbox One and PS4, a few interesting features designed to make your playthrough more enjoyable, and lots more. Let's begin. For those of you still keeping an open mind towards game streaming, Google and CDPR recently teamed up to show off the game running on Stadia. The 5-minute trailer shows off the game's 4K visuals. And if you're entertaining the idea of trying Stadia for yourself, purchasing Cyberpunk on the platform before December 17th will net you a Stadia Premiere Kit, which includes a white Stadia controller and the Chromecast Ultra for free, along with a 1-month subscription to Stadia Pro if you're completely new to the service. But please do consider your internet speeds, as it could greatly affect your results. A fact that isn't helped by Google not disclosing what kind of devices or internet speeds were used to record their own footage for that trailer. One thing Cyberpunk isn't lacking is player choice, but a few features have recently come to light to not only give you more choices throughout your playthrough, but make it more convenient as well. It recently came to light that players will be able to toggle nudity on and off. For those of you who may not be comfortable with it in-game, or just playing around others who might not want to see it, or those of you who might stream it yourselves. For the content creators among you, the ability to toggle off copyrighted music will also save you a headache or two. On console, the feature will kick on automatically, if you're recording natively through your Xbox or PlayStation, but it can be manually toggled on or off for those of you using capture cards or similar devices. On PC, you'll also find it in the game settings. CDPR also confirmed recently that every save file is marked with your corresponding life path. That way, players rolling multiple characters can easily distinguish their playthroughs and save files. And speaking of save files, you'll be happy to know that Cyberpunk 2077 will also have cross-gen saving, meaning your PS4 save file will be able to migrate to PS5, and your Xbox One save will be usable on your Xbox Series console of choice. For those of you who aren't big Stadia fans but still haven't made the jump to PS5 or the Series X, you'll be pleased to know that CDPR devs are happy with the performance they've been able to get out of the PS4 and Xbox One. In a recent financial call, CD Projekt's president and joint CEO, Adam Kaczynski, was asked about performance on older consoles, stating, "Of course the performance is a bit lower than on the pros, but surprisingly good, I'd say, for such a huge world. So, a bit lower, but very good, that's the answer." He went on to say, "And on both, I mean, PS5 is great. PS4 is still very good. I mean, we had those extra 3 weeks and we achieved a lot within this final stretch. So we believe that the game is performing great on every platform." In the past few weeks, CDPR has been releasing more gameplay on various platforms in order for you to make the decision for yourself. I've also taken the liberty of adding all those links into the description below. Personally, I noticed the decreased lighting effects, reflections, and frames on older hardware. But I doubt any of those factors would substantially detract from what's otherwise a seemingly impressive game. And it's worth noting that even if you do buy a copy on older hardware, you can automatically transfer it to your newer console, whenever you do manage to pick one up, as the game is backward compatible. But that wasn't all we learned from the aforementioned earnings call, as CD Projekt offered updates on things like the upcoming DLC and multiplayer. The studio's original plan was to announce Cyberpunk's DLC and story expansions prior to the game's release. But after so many delays, plans were pushed further and further away. Now it turns out that any DLC or season pass announcements will take place after the game's initial release. Throughout the game's development, CDPR has often stated that they'll use the same DLC and expansion model as they did with The Witcher 3. And it seems that they're sticking to that plan, with Kaczynski once again reiterating that Cyberpunk will have, quote, "no less DLC than The Witcher 3 had," which for those who might not remember or might not know, The Witcher 3 received 2 paid expansions with an additional 30 hours of gameplay and 16 pieces of DLC. In terms of multiplayer, it seems we won't be hearing more about it until Q1 of next year, either at a dedicated event or as part of the company's full-year financial results, which are usually announced around March. Kaczynski did, however, reiterate that the multiplayer is a standalone project, being treated like its own AAA production. It'll be separate from Cyberpunk 2077, but be inspired by that single-player experience, and of course, set in the same universe. We'll be seeing it at the very earliest in 2022. It's also worth restating that a separate team is working on that multiplayer release. For more on this story, make sure to check out my Everything We Know About Cyberpunk's multiplayer video by clicking in the top right now or at the end of this video. But that's it for this Cyberpunk news update. If you haven't, check out one of my Cyberpunk lore dives. And while you're at it, make sure to get subbed for more coverage of this game through its release. I'll be providing more news updates, weapon reviews, guides, and much, much more. And as always, thanks for watching, guys.